I'm going to say it now. We're not going to mention female custodies.
Nope. Ambrosia, Devon, Custard. It's all those tins ready to fight for the Emperor. We're going to do an army breakdown, and we're going to do it now.
Welcome back to The Kieran Show. It's time to break down another army release. The Golden Custard boys have had their codex. We know how many points they all are.
Mm.
They kind of look like a Horde army off the cuff of it.
Yeah, how much does a Custodes army cost now? We're looking at 2,000 points. We've done it for all of the releases for 10th edition so far. It's been quite an exciting exercise, really.
Yeah, so this one's an interesting one because, obviously, with the Custards, you don't get too many miniatures in general.
No, so I have done this, or I've actually done the next two for Custodes and Orcs, which we'll see very, very shortly. For Custards, for what I thought was going to be a very low model count, they got a huge points nerf. Nerf? Is that the right word?
Points. No. Points nerf would be the points going up.
Ah, the opposite. The opposite of points nerf. The points
drop.
I should have said that. The points went down. So I remember when we saw the data slate quickly after the release, we went, oh, are they a Horde army now? I think that Custodes players have kicked off about the new book.
Yeah, people are
for some reason anyway, but
we'll mention it now. There's been a lot of controversy about the Custodes that we're not going to go into. There's 6,034 YouTube videos you can go and watch about that if you want.
But we will preface that Kieran obviously mentioned the Golden Boys. It's now the Golden People, and that is where we're going to leave that. For the Custodes, I have included 5 kits.
So this is going to be a shorter one.
Short video, very short video. It's a very low model count, but I thought, considering with the new boxes you get, as in for the combat patrol and stuff, I don't think it's bad, but
yeah,
it might not be very competitive, but it's absolutely, by a mile, the cheapest army we've ever done.
Yeah, so we'll preface this, as we always do with these. This is all G-dubs RRP. You can absolutely save between 10 and 20% with our affiliate links or your local gaming store. It's also accurate of Munitor and Field Manual 1.8, isn't it? I think we're on now.
I'm going to take your word for it because I didn't check the numbers. I just check it when they release.
Yeah, whichever one came out last week. Yeah. That's the one we're going with.
Yeah. And for the people that are, well, the two people that like Tau, me and the person watching that might like Tau, we'll do Tau in a couple of weeks' time and when we fully get that codex. It might have dropped before, but we're still waiting on points.
Yeah, just a word on that. The way they've handled the points in these 10th edition books is a little strange. I can't remember the last one that happened, but the points came out in the book and then 2 days later the points were wrong.
For Orcs and Custodes, it was same day, I think. Yeah. Same day? Oh, same week.
Yeah,
it was even better than that. The book came out on the Saturday and the new points were released on the Thursday prior. What is the point in even putting points in a book? Just stop it.
Well, let's not open the book debate.
It's fine. It's fine because we're all here, we're all enjoying this, and we're talking about golden people.
Let's get into it. What's the first custard?
We are starting off with 2 combat patrol boxes.
Two. So what's really funny is when we came up with this idea, I said to Kira, I was like, we can't use too many of the same boxes because that feels like you're cheesing it. However, the custard one is really good.
Yeah.
So what do you get in it?
So just off the bat, you get a blade champion. So by addition, we've got 2 blade champions. So that totals 220 points, 110 points each. And not a bad start.
What else is in that box?
You also get 3 Alaris Custodians, so you're getting 6. So they come in, I think they come in units of 2 now, which is interesting. And you can flex up to 3, which I thought was interesting.
I'll take your word on that.
So you could either have 2 units of 3 or 3 units of 2. Either way, do what you want. But having 2 units of 3 is 390 points, which I think was quite high, considering you only get 6 models. But Custodians, what are you going to do? They are thick. Yeah,
like
I think
Terminators on roids.
So in my experience playing against Custodes, they've always been a horrible time to try and shift. I'm just going to preface this relatively early in the video. This is mainly foot sloggers, but from what I've seen, Custodes tend to be built that way anyway.
They're slow moving up the board. So I've only ever played against Custodes once, and that was in 9th edition. I took Drakari, and this was when Dark Lance was very prevalent.
Mm.
And I did just every shot was a dead custard, which felt quite cool. But felt very OP, given that these are...
supposed to be like the Emperor's finest.
They're like Space Marines on roids. They're just insane.
Well, speaking of Space Marines on roids, next up we've got two lots of five Custodian Wardens. So 10 total. That comes in at 500 points. 250 points per five.
Okay.
I don't know the real difference between Wardens and Guard. I just know that Guard are the battle line units. The last unit in the combat patrol is five Custodian Guard. So five Custodian Guard times two comes in at 450 points. So there's a 50-point difference or 25-point difference per unit of five, which is very cool.
So that's two combat patrol boxes.
Two combat patrol boxes. That sets you back £190 for two boxes, because they're £95 each.
That's pretty good. I think... if you did want to potentially go with some flavour and not double up, if you could still find the old Custodes Combat Patrol in stock, buy one of it, the new one and the old one, you've got some nice... and you get the bikes. And the bikes are very cool.
Which brings me on to my next point. So just with those alone, we are down, call it 400 points. So with two Combat Patrol boxes, that's 1,600 points. Which is mental. So this is where I tried to include some flavour. So Trajan Valoris is next.
You have to go with a name character, and no matter what anyone, like all of these armies, when we do them, there has to be the big person to lead them. So all the Space Marines have always had the Primarch, if there is one. The Orcs will have certain people because it's cool.
Yeah.
Necrons had Silent King.
Yeah, you just go with some cooler options. And I think Trajan Valoris is absolutely one of those. I think he's got a pretty wicked looking model.
I was going to ask you that. What do you think of his mini? I'm not a massive fan of the miniature.
So we've been chatting about this week. I would quite like to do some Custodians in the future with a slight twist that you said wasn't necessarily fit for YouTube at the current climate.
Yeah. But people are already doing them on Instagram. So. Oh,
good. Yeah.
Yeah, but you'd have to paint them blue.
Oh yeah, I forgot about the blue scheme.
The one that you got concocted on the way over.
Oh no.
Your Ultramarine Custodes.
Rubbish.
Do you know what the cool person does? And if I was to ever do custodes, I would buy Constantine Valdor's miniature from Forge World, and I would run that as Trajan Valoris.
That's infinitely cooler as a miniature.
That miniature is just...
there's a lot going on there, isn't
it? It's resin, so you've got, you know,
I think it's
a lot going on.
It's certainly one of the nicer Heresy characters.
I think it's one of the newer ones, isn't it? You compare that to, just as a tangent, the Angron miniature that looks like a potato in comparison to Transfigured Fulgrim.
Yeah, wildly different. But that's another video. We'll get on to some of those. But yeah, Trajan Valoris sets you back 150 points and £27.50.
It's not the best point to pound ratio, is it?
It's not, but it's, to be honest, we've just spent £190 on 1,600 points, so I mean, it had to happen eventually.
Okay.
It's also a character model at G Dubs. It's either 2250 or 2750, depending on size. I think it's base size.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's
fine. I mean, if you've got some extra pocket money and you want to do what I did, the Constantine Valdor miniature is £90.
Go do that, because it's cooler. Unless you're in Australia and don't do any of these things.
Yeah, in which case, just push cardboard around, because one out.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe just like do little cardboard pop-up figures instead.
Like in second edition, when you used to have the Killican thing.
Then again, if this is the price of Warhammer, I dread to think what the cost of paper is out there. Next up is Virtus Praetors, so the three-man bike squad. I had to fit some bikes in because it felt very like men on the ground, or people on the ground, pardon me, and then just running up the board. Whereas the Virtus Praetors add some sort of speed, I guess. I would have liked to have had more, but the value for the combat patrol seemed utterly insane not to double up on.
The Custodes very much carried on the theme they've had for a couple of years. Their combat patrol / start collecting box, when those were introduced, have always been the best value.
Yeah, I think so. It just because it's such a low model count army, though, isn't it? And that army box that was released with the Codex, I think, had a lot of the things that were included, but then had six bikes as well.
So
but it's interesting.
At the time of recording, obviously that's just come out, and the stock for that one is a bit scarce. If you can find that, bin off the two combat patrol boxes,
get that
go
instead.
And buy that Battle Force box. Sell the Mushroom Shield, man,
yeah.
Because it is hot but...
Yeah, just throw that in the bin. Just get rid of
it. Yeah, not fun on that miniature.
What's really fun about the Virtus Praetor kit as well, I think that also is another one of the Custodes that comes in units of two, then you flex up. What's really amazing, again, for versatility with the Custodes kits, you could turn one of them into a shield captain on bike, which is a wicked very mini cool. Anyway. So, yeah, just do that. I think there's something about bare-headed Custodians that I like more than the helmets. I think because they're just like...
I think it's because... Thick. It, yeah.
Thick.
Never do that again.
I'm sorry.
We are getting divorced, my guy, now. after that.
But yeah, three Virtus Praetors takes you back 225 points or £37.50, which isn't a bad ratio.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I think because there's quite a few people that obviously bought the Custodian box, some people won't want... I think... correct me if I'm wrong, that came with six bikes, didn't it, in the Battlefield spot? So. I think they might be a good eBay buy at the minute.
The last Combat Patrol had three in them as well. So the thing is,
if you find that in stock, get the new one and the old one. You've got, like I said earlier, you've got a good looking Custodes army there.
You do. I think the only thing about the existing Combat Patrol I wasn't totally keen on is that it had loads of Sisters of Silence in there. And I think they're fine, but I think if you're going full gold squad, I don't think that they'd be necessarily important. I don't know how good they are in the game. They might be utter tosh.
I don't know what they're like in the new book. They were okay in the 9th edition book.
That left me in a really weird position because then I had 65 points to play with, and there is absolutely nothing in this book that costs you 65 points.
I mean,
points.
You could buy, if you were to ever run this as an actual army, you could run it with an attachment of some description.
So I did look, and you can run five Sisters of Silence, which costs like, I think it's like 50 or 60 points. It's around that number anyway.
Yeah.
But the box of five Sisters of Silence costs you like 30 or 40 quid.
Yeah, it's a weird price point.
Yeah, and I just didn't understand that. So I went, well, consider I'm essentially doing this for optimum value, I went with a really old tosh miniature, and I went with an Inquisitor.
What?
So, the Inquisitor model looks like butt, but it's 55 points and only £14.
Yeah, but there's a reason.
There is a reason. So the best thing with Inquisitors is that they come in so many different shapes and sizes. You can also get an assassin if you wanted to instead.
I was about to say, can you not just do the cool guy thing and run a Vindicare?
You could, but assassins cost a lot more in points. I think they cost around the 100 mark, so it wouldn't fit in the 2,000.
You couldn't fit the Vindicare in.
No, so there are some really cool looking Inquisitor kits, and plus I've seen some amazing little kit bashes or like reworks. You can get a Necromunda, or a Necromunda model, or yeah, you can do what you want essentially with Inquisitors because they all look really different, and you can do like different orders and stuff. But yeah, the one that looks like hot butt is £14 and 55 points, and I think works quite nicely with it. Custodes Force. How well it is, I don't know, but yeah, I thought it was cool.
It's fluffy in some respects.
I can already feel...
Depending on what happens with the Imperial Agents in 10th edition, whether they get a fully fleshed out book or not.
Yeah, well, I mean, at the moment, you can, so I did. And I think it looks quite cool. There's obviously, we mentioned at the beginning, you can have some like versatility. I think if I was to personally run a Custodes army, there are some bits in the Combat Patrol that I wouldn't run twice. For example, I'd probably only use one Blade Champion. The concept of 20 warrior warden/guard sounds very big and very like fluffy.
I mean, that's a hench list to play against because Custodians are hard to shift.
It is rubbish, but you've also then got six... Alaris Terminators or Custodians or whatever they're called. Yeah, the Terminators, the really thick one. So I'm like, there's lots of boots on the ground. How do you shift those around?
I mean, I'm not a Custodians fan, but the thought of buying two of those Combat Patrol boxes, and having that thick, that does sound quite fun.
It does sound fun.
Enabling me.
Well, I think if you were to run loads of those and then also include that
Valdor as well,
Constantine Valdor. That would look mad cool.
Do the thick thing again, because I refuse to do that on the
thick
internet. That's how it would feel.
But yeah, no, it'd look really, really cool. And I think, especially if you had like played it fluffily, if you played it fluffy, I'm just gonna say that. Please don't cap that. Please don't cap that. if you ran it as like Valdor coming out of the warp 10,000 years later with his like squaddy of gold boys, that have just been on the run for the last 10,000 years. How cool would that be?
Forgive my ignorance, but what is Valdor... just as a small lore tangent, because what is Valdor doing these days?
what he wants. I quite like that as an idea, though. The fact that he's just kicking about in the warp somewhere. It's, again, this is what Games Workshop does, though, isn't it? It's just like, oh, we've got these really cool characters. We're just going to not talk about them for a while. And then when people go, hang on, what's Valdor doing? If enough people start saying it, they'll then release a mini and be like, let's make loads of money. Because business. But yeah, so in total, that is 1,990 points. Take a guess how much it is in pounds.
£580.
£269. £269 for that.
I'll buy three.
It's mental.
What's hilarious is you could buy that list three. You could buy that three times, and that would cost as much as
all of the other armies we've done.
Yeah, so far they've been between 500 to 600, depending.
Yep, this is half the price. But then again, it's half the model count, so yeah. It is what it is. If you're getting into Warhammer or you want like a really small elite army, this is perfect.
I think absolutely perfect. As well, just as a tick for custards in general, if you've not got the hobby time, they're a great army to paint. Like, someone has he comes up in how many videos when you talk about custodes, but Henry Cavill, that guy's schedule, there's probably a reason he's doing custodes, because it's such a few model count.
I also imagine he's a massive Emperor simp as well. He loves
Imperium. He is basically a custodian.
Yeah.
Look at the size of him.
I bet he hates Xenos armies. Hates them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I reckon he's like a proper diehard Imperium fan.
Well, me and him would get on very well.
Henry, if you're watching, I obviously don't mean that. I really want to be your mate. £269 in UK sterling. It's £448 in US dollars.
It's not £448 in US dollars, is it? It's $448 in US dollars.
That is exactly what I mean. I'm sorry. €352 for the Europeans. And then $721 Australian dollary dues. And considering how awful the Australians have had it, I didn't think that was that bad.
It's the first one we've done that hasn't crossed 1,000 Australian dollary dues.
Yeah, I mean, normally we're like, pull one out for Australia and
I mean, still pull one out when this is £200.
It's very expensive, but yeah. I tell you what, if I was into 40k and I lived over in Oz, I think I'd have to play this team.
I think you'd have to play a different game and company.
Or Knights, mate. Oh, yeah, maybe just maybe just don't play Warhammer at all.
Yeah.
But yeah, really cool. And I think considering you're getting a 2,000 point army for £269, I think that's solid. As we've already mentioned, there is some changes that we might make. I'm really slurring my words today. I'm not having a good time. But we'd also love to know what changes you'd make. So please write down in the comments below. If you were to run Custodes, if you do run Custodes, what do you think is competitive? What do you think is amazing value?
And if you're a custodian buff, let us know what we did wrong.
Yes, because that's also really important. We would love as much criticism as possible, because otherwise we just don't learn and then we grow old and ignorant, or at least more so. But yeah, we'd like to take a huge, huge thank you to all the people on this left-hand side of the screen, all of you lovely Kierans. We love you immensely.
If you want to get your name in there somewhere.
In there.
Head over to Patreon or click the join button on YouTubes.
Exactly. And quite recently, we've been doing our very first live stream. So keep an eye out on socials and on YouTube as well. And you can maybe catch us in the next one, which is very cool indeed. But yeah, anything else to add for the golden peeps?
No, just do your thick thing again and we'll end.
Thick! And then we're done. Bye.